So I want you to be mindful. I'm not saying do not use modern day technology. I'm not saying don't be aware of modern day technology. But what I'm saying is don't let technology supplant your skills as a physician, because technology cannot feel, cannot have compassion, cannot have sensitivity. It may be objective, but it cannot adequately communicate with the patient. And do you recognize that many patients will get well with you or without you? Do you also recognize that some patients will get well in spite of you? But many patients will depend on you to determine whether or not they get well. And you can find those patients that will respond better to whatever treatment that you might give because they have faith and confidence in you. How do they get that? They get that because you will take the time to sit down and ask them simple questions. Like, I was talking to a patient and he said to me, "Doc, I don't understand you. My voice has been going, and I'm losing my voice all the time. What's the diagnosis? What's the diagnosis? What's the diagnosis? Do you have any idea?" Think, I'm saying. If you've had that for 6 weeks, the diagnosis is cancer of the larynx until it's proven otherwise. But if you don't get that history, you'll never know. So somebody out there in California who gets an x-ray of the whole body, mind you, they'll never know if this patient has cancer of the larynx because it only is manifest by persistent hoarseness. Patient comes to the office and say, "Doc, my eyes are turning yellow. What's the diagnosis?" You should immediately think there is an obstructive jaundice somewhere here. Think history. "Doc, I haven't had a bowel movement in 6 weeks." "Oh my God, you're in deep trouble." But there's such a thing as obstipation, a progressive constipation, where a patient may have bowel movement, but they get less and less and less for a period of time. You only elicit that by history. An x-ray can't tell you that. CAT scan can't tell you. MRI can't tell you that. It's very important that you get an adequate history and do that physical examination using the hands and using the stethoscope. So having practiced, as I did, in rural Georgia, with very limited resources, so far as laboratory imaging was concerned, and learned how to make diagnosis in the absence of it, makes me even appreciate more the practice of today. And you wonder, why does the cost of practice continue to go up? A lot of it is attributed to technology. Steve Jobs has done a magnificent job in making much of this technology available to us. And my friend Rhea Howe back there, she and I were watching this TV special where autistic kids now are using the iPad. All of you have iPad, don't you? "You don't have an iPad? What the hell wrong with you? Wait a minute. I thought all of you had second generation iPads. You don't have first generation, you gotta have an iPad." Well, I'm kidding, all of them. But what I'm saying is though that modern day technology has opened up a whole new world for diagnosis, for communication, for keeping records. And mind you, when you get to that point where you're now moving into the hospital at the end of your second year, you're going to get introduced to electronic health records or electronic medical records. You're going to get introduced to that. And if you are afraid of technology now, if you don't have an iPad, buddy, you're going to be out of luck. You know that? Because in most hospitals, you are required to use electronic records, and it's just a matter of time before the government is going to require you to use electronic medical health records, or you're not going to get paid. As a matter of fact, standard of practice is going to be medical health records or electronic health records. That would be, I got to go. That would be the standard of practice. Now let me leave you with this thought. There is a danger in getting lulled to sleep in thinking that I really don't need to know that much. I really do not need to develop my palpatory skills. I do need to develop my auscultatory skills. Because we're going to have some dumbass surgeon like that when they call his emergency room and say, "Did you get an MRI yet?" There's a real danger in those of us who now are in this new world of electronics, modern day technology. We have so much of reliance on it, we will forget about the basic and fundamental things of the practice of medicine, history, and physical. Use your your mind, use your hands, and use your stethoscope. The next time I come to see you, bring your iPad. Bring your stethoscope. Where's that fucking cardiologist? We run through the cap on the stethoscope, stuff on tissue paper, and he still heard heart sounds. It's all imagination, people. Well, thank you very much, and good luck to all of you, and I'm sorry I cannot have more time with you. I'd love to do that, but I'll be around in a couple of days. If you won't stop me in the hall, stop me and ask me, well, what did you do down in Georgia? If you had a patient, they had a sore belly. Sometimes I hope they got better. All right, thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Anderson.